Let's start the new session, the rate analysis of brick masonry work in cement mortar 1:4 in superstructure, that is ground floor. Let's take the quantity 10 cubic meter. The 10 cubic meter will be the quantity for brick masonry work. Let's calculate the amount required for 10 cubic meter, then we can easily work out the rate per cubic meter. The IS standard size of the brick is 190 by 90 by 90, 190 mm in length, 90 mm in height, 90 mm in width. This is the IS standard size of the brick. There are other sizes which are available in the market. There is no doubt at all. Now, I am going to take this IS standard size of a brick. Okay. Now, the size of a brick including mortar. 200 mm by 100 mm by 100 mm, because while brick masonry work is being carried out, to bond the two units, that is two bricks, a mortar is used as a binding material. That's why we apply mortar on either side of the brick. Therefore, now the size of the brick is increased to 200 mm by 100 mm by 100 mm. Which includes the mortar also. This size is without the mortar and this is with the mortar. Let's start the material calculation. What are the basic materials for brick masonry work? First one, the brick itself, as the name suggests, brick masonry work. The most one is brick itself. The next one is mortar. In mortar, again, there are two materials. One is cement and another one is sand. Let's start the calculation of brick. Number of bricks required. We know we are working out for 10 cubic meter. This is the volume of the brick work. And we know the volume of one brick including mortar now. 0.2 into 0.1 into 0.1. This is being converted into meters. Where I have written this is in mm, 200 mm by 100 mm by 100 mm. Now I have converted in meters. That is 0.2 meter by 0.1 meter by 0.1 meter. I'll be getting number of bricks, that is 5000 numbers. This number is not going to vary now. This number is a constant for this standard size of a brick. Now let's calculate the quantity of mortar. What is the total quantity, total volume? 10 cubic meter. In that, 5000 number of bricks are there. And what is the size of the brick without the mortar? It is 0.19 by 0.09 by 0.09. This is the volume of a single brick without the mortar. Now I have been multiplying it to number of bricks, that is 5000. 5000 into a volume of a single brick, I will be getting the value. And that will be subtracted from 10 cubic meter total quantity of brick masonry work. The remaining quantity will be a mortar. There are only two brick materials here. One is brick and another is mortar. If I subtract the volume of the brick from the total quantity, the remaining quantity will be the mortar. That quantity I have got it as 2.3 cubic meter. This is nothing but the wet quantity here. Wet quantity. Now, I'll be adding 15% extra. I'll be adding how much? 15% extra for frog filling, because there is a depression at the top of the brick. Here it is being provided. It is being provided to have a proper bonding between two units. So the mortar is being filled over this frog also. So that's why I'm adding 15% extra and wastage. A wastage is very minimum. So I'm including here itself, that is 15% in 15% itself. Now, the volume of the mortar stands as 2.3 into 1.15. This is 0.15 is the 15% extra. 0.15 is the 15% extra. 2.3 into 1.15, I'll be getting the volume as 2.64 cubic meter. Either you can also calculate in this way, 2.3 plus 15% of again 2.3, you'll be getting the same value as 2.64 cubic meter. This is also a wet volume itself. But at a dry condition, the required quantity is more. That's why I'm adding another 1/3% extra, or the 35% extra. You can either add one third or 35% extra. I am adding a one third extra. Now, because a dry volume, it is dry volume, you know, the motor gate shrinks. The motor gate shrinks and even contains voids in the dry condition. That will be all the voids will get be will be removed. Therefore, the volume get reduced. Now, the volume of the motor, the volume of the motor is being taken as 2.64 plus one third into 2.64. One third of again 2.64. The volume of the motor comes as 3.5 cubic meter. This is the volume of the motor. Now, the required quantity of the motor is 3.5 cubic meter. Now, the motor volume, we know that is 3.5 cubic meter. We also know the cement motor is in proportion of 1:4 as it is described in the beginning. Therefore, now in a motor, we have two materials. One is cement and another one is sand. The total quantity of motor is 3.5 divided by the given proportion of the motor, that is 1 plus 4. Given sum of the given proportion here, again 1 plus 4, 3.5 divided by 5 into 1. 1 part is cement, 4 part is sand. Therefore, I am multiplying it by 1. I am getting the quantity of cement. Now, the quantity of cement is 0.7 cubic meter. 1 bag of cement is equal to 50 kg and it will be having a volume of 0.0347 cubic meter. Therefore, number of bags is equal to 0.7 cubic meter divided by a volume of 1 bag, that is 0.0347. I will be getting as 20.17. I am rounding it off to 21 number of bags. This is the quantity of cement. Let's calculate the quantity of sand. Again, similarly, the total quantity of motor is 3.5 divided by the sum of the given proportion into 4. 4 part of sand is there. That's why it is multiplied by 4. Now I am getting it as 2.8 cubic meter. This is the quantity of sand. Okay. See, one thing which I have done here, just I want to tell. For a dry volume, I have added one third extra. Whereas for a concrete, I have added 52 to 54%. Remember, whenever there is a mortar, we need to add one third or 35% extra for a dry volume. For a mortar, it is always 50 to 54%. You remember, these are the changes. While you are working out for concrete, you need to add 52 to 54% extra for a dry volume. Whereas for a mortar, you need to add one third or 35% extra to get the quantity of mortar. Okay, that is only for the dry volume. Okay, now I am working as I have taken this tabular column to work out the rate analysis. Usually we use this tabular column to work out the rate analysis. First one, material which we have calculated, brick, cement, sand, 5000 numbers, 21 numbers, 2.8 respectively, and the rates I have written 5 rupees per brick, 300 rupees per bag cement, 900 rupees per cubic meter sand, then the total amount I have generated here. Similarly, labor, head mason 1 number, 500 rupees, mason 8 numbers, mazdoor 16 numbers, 450, 400 respectively, the amount I have generated. Contingencies, unavoidable cost which comes during the construction, I have taken it as lump sum as again 500 rupees. I have added 500 rupees. The total cost came as 44,820 is the cost. In that, 2% is water charges, overhead expenses and contractor's profit 10%. Adding these two, I have got an amount of grand total as 50,198 rupees. I am rounding it off to 50,200 rupees. Now rate per cubic meter 50,200 divided by 10. I got it as rupees 5020 per cubic meter. This is the cost of brick masonry work. Only the changes here. Sometimes brick masonry work is being carried out in the cement mortar of 1:4, 1:6, 1:3. As this ratio gets changes, you need to change this the proportion, some of the given proportion to calculate the material here. Only this you need to change it. Everything again remains same. Even if the size of the brick is given different, you need to take that size of the brick itself. Okay, this how the masonry work, brick masonry work is being calculated. I want to again share few things about the stone masonry work also. Usually when we work out for a stone masonry work, we again take 10 cubic meter quantity. Always remember stone, the stone required is 12.5 cubic meter. For 10 cubic meter, I am taking it as 12.5 cubic meter. Again 25% extra. 25% extra I am taking for a stone masonry. Whatever may be the kind of, whatever type of a stone masonry it is, either it may be a random rubble masonry, coarse rubble masonry, ashlar masonry, only the this mortar quantity will get altered, whereas the stone quantity will not get altered. This remains same, 12.5 itself, that is 25% extra. Now for random rubble masonry, quantity dry volume, it is complete, need not to add any other percentage. It is 4.2 cubic meter for random rubble masonry. For coarse rubble masonry, it is 4 cubic meter. Ashlar masonry, 2.5 cubic meter. This is the standard one. Okay, 4.2, 4, 2.5 for random rubble masonry, coarse rubble masonry, ashlar masonry, respectively. You need not to add any extra percentage here. Directly divided by given proportion, and you can calculate the quantity of cement and sand. This is how it is been calculated, the masonry work. Even here, I have written it for, I said it at the beginning, the brickwork is carried out for stone masonry work. Brickwork is been carried out in superstructure at a ground floor. Here, we did not add scaffolding. We need to add scaffolding also. The fourth item, we can also add fourth item, scaffolding, lump sum, 500 rupees. Even that amount can also be considered here. In the second floor, lift charge is need to be added. Lifting charge. Again, that rate will also get altered. Okay. This is how the brick masonry work and stone masonry work is being carried out. Thank you. I will be carrying out the next session here. With the cement plastering. Let's continue with the next video. Thank you.